Every person is born with a special ability. Carlos had the ability to work well with people. George had the ability to work well with technology. And Lorena had the ability to work well with the part of you that was easily annoyed.
Lorena, knock it off.
Then let me on the computer.
Don't touch me. I was here first.
You've been on for an hour. Besides, I want to check out a new website.
Let me guess. Daintytoes.web?
No, amazinggirls.web.
Oh, why didn't you say so?
Now I really don't care. Then it's for important stuff.
Like what?
Like checking out Vitamin C's new webpage.
Hey, bro, I need to email Marina that I'm going to a party Saturday.
Okay.
Yes. Send.
Hey, guys, can I get on and see the latest space shuttle pictures of Mars?
Sure, bro, just a sec.
Okay. Hello, does anybody see me?
Yeah, we see you. Now disappear.
Hey, it's good to see you all doing something together for a change.
We're not. The boys won't let me on the computer, Mommy.
Mom, we're just trying to protect Lorena. Technology's a mass medium. She could get hurt.
She should stick to girl stuff.
Yeah, like baking cookies.
We Garcia brothers had our own tradition. Girls were girls, and men were men, and luckily for us, we outnumbered them. Yeah.
Boys! In the Garcia family, everyone gets equal time on the internet. And Lorena's time starts now. Ahora.
Funny how equal time seemed more like Lorena just getting her way again.
Bye. Have fun, mija.
Who you become depends a lot on the family you grew up in. Is your family helping you become a go-get-it girl? Or a let-me-get-that-for-you girl? Take this test. One. No. Two. Double no. Three. Big fat no.
The changing of the status quo was as easy as no, a double no, and a big fat no.
Oh, no.
Lorena, could you pass me some juice?
I refuse to become a slave to a male overlord, so the answer is no.
Ooh, she called you an overlord.
I'm not an overlord. Dad, what's an overlord?
Someone who's always telling people what to do. Memoir, pour me some coffee.
Coming right up.
Why doesn't Dad pour his own coffee, Mommy?
What's up with you today? Did someone tell you TV's looking for a new teenage witch?
That's not nice, Carlos. Apologize to your sister.
Thanks, Bobby, but you don't need to rescue me. I'm not a subjugated female.
All right, you have our attention. What's up, Lorena?
Well, yesterday I took a test on this new website to see if I was a go-get-it girl.
Well, were you?
No, I was a let-me-get-that-for-you girl. But it's not my fault. Everything's stacked against me. Did you know that in school, boys are called on more than girls because they're louder?
Says who? We're not louder.
Shh.
And girls often fall behind boys academically because they have a lot of pressure on them to look good.
I do too. Do you have any idea how much pressure it is to look like this every day?
And Dad, did you know that society still expects girls to choose marriage over a career and then doesn't offer homemakers the same respect as career women? What do you think of that?
Lucky for us, we're boys.
That's enough. What your sister's saying is unfortunately true, and I don't think it's anything to joke about.
Yeah, and I'm glad you're taking an interest in such an important issue. Who wants to play hoops till breakfast is ready?
I do.
I'm in.
Me too. Great, what am I supposed to do? Put on an apron and help you cook?
Sure, that'll be fun. I'm making waffles.
Mom, I don't know how to break it to you, but I don't think you're a go-get-it girl.
That's ridiculous. I am too a go-get-it girl. Give me that test.
Okay, Mom, here's the last question. When you get up in the morning, what's the first thing you do?
What is watch cartoons?
What is put a sock in it, George?
Mom, you're making the pants too short. The cool kids let them drag on the ground. And the waist is supposed to be right here, so people can see your boxers.
If you want people to see your boxers, take an extra pair to school.
Come on, Mom, we're almost done. When you get up in the morning, what's the first thing you do?
Tell your father he slept through the alarm again.
Are you sure you don't think of all the big things you hope to accomplish that day?
Believe me, getting your father out of bed in the morning is a big accomplishment.
Okay, that's all the questions. Let's see. You got a 93.
A 93? Well, hey, that's a nice high score.
Not when the best score is one. Mom, it's worse than I thought. Here we go get a clue, girl.
Come on in, Marina. Mom, this is Marina. Marina, this is my beautiful mother and my two cool bros, Larry and George. Oh, and that's Lerna.
It's nice to meet all of you.
Very nice to meet you, too.
You're always welcome in our house. Even when Carlos isn't around. Mi casa es tu casa.
Mrs. Garcia, your boys are so sweet.
That's because you're not related to them. Actually, they're typical self-centered male chauvinistic pigs.
Lorena, yeah.
Could I fix you something to eat? I make a mean quesadilla.
You cook, too? Is there anything you can't do?
Say no to you, Marina. Let's go out to the patio where it's cooler.
Woohoo! Bye.
See, Lorena, if he was a chauvinist, he wouldn't have offered to cook for her.
Mom, can you whip up some quesadillas? Thanks, you're the best. And while you're at it, can you make some for me and Larry, too? Thanks. Let's go check out the babe.
Don't call her a babe. She's a cutie.
Woo-hoo! Bye.
No puede ser. Are my sons male chauvinist
puercos?
I love it when it's quiet like this.
Just the two of us snuggling. This is nice.
You know, it would really be nice.
What?
If you vacuum the house tomorrow.
Ray, it's your turn to do it.
I know, but I was wondering if you'd do it. I've been working so hard lately.
I work just as hard as you do.
Of course you do. But it's a different kind of hard. Teaching is very demanding. All the lecturing and the grading and dealing with all those egos.
You think you work harder than I do, don't you? Well, okay, let's take today. Let's take Saturday. What did you do?
Well, that's not really fair. Saturday's my day off.
Oh, well, would you like to hear what I did on my day off? I made breakfast. I polished the furniture. I did the sewing. I made lunch. I paid the bills. I did the groceries. I made dinner. I cleaned the oven, and I worked in the salon for 6 hours.
Well, if that's how you choose to spend your Saturday, is it really my fault?
Oh, no wonder the boys are making sexist comments.
What?
And it's partially my fault for failing that amazing girls test, which would not have happened if you would get your own self out of bed in the morning.
Okay, I'll do the vacuuming.
This is not about the vacuuming, Ray. This is about everything. And from now on, things are going to be different around here.
They are?
Yes.
My dad didn't know it yet, but in retrospect, he should have just vacuumed.
Lord, we ask that you bless this delicious meal
and the lovely hands that prepared it. Amen.
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 Well, mijos, your father and I had a long talk last night, and we have some great news. From now on, all the Garcias are equal.
Now, you know what this means, boys?
I know what it means. It means amazing girls unite.
It means everyone gets the same treatment and rights.
Thanks for coming through, Papi.
Hey, Dad, did you come through with those hockey tickets?
Well, I don't know. Let me see. What do we have here? A pair of tickets and... Oh, Mita, another pair!
All right!
Cool.
You're awesome.
Yeah, thanks, Dad. I can't wait.
Lorena, I didn't know you wanted to go.
Isn't that what equality means, that I get to do what the boys get to do?
I had no problem with the equality thing, okay? I just didn't think Lorena should be able to do the same things as us.
Remember the last time I took you? You hated it.
I didn't hate it. I just didn't know it involved boxing.
But I only have 4 tickets.
And the problem is?
Simple math, Mom. Lorena makes 5. Odd girl out.
Yeah, for Lorena to go, I'd have to give her my seat and sit in the lounge.
Thanks, Papi.
You're welcome.
Another male Garcia tradition knocked down. We had never been to a hockey game without him. Poor Dad, this was just not right. At a very young age, Carlos knew the ins and outs of economics. He knew that money could get you from outside to inside, just like that with the school janitor. Most school sports were fun because they were played under a banner. But there was one that was more fun because it was just plain banned. Locker Soccer Sunday. That's what I'm talking about.
Let's do this. All young girls be wet. Let's pump up the chains. A pretty little something out here putting down pain. Since I was 6, running with the pound. It's been going down. From city to city, town to town. They running up, screaming my name. Running up, lining my chain. Running up, trying to get in the game. I'm like, Mom, don't get it twisted. If you can't get your punk on. Hope to God you see me again when I'm grown. Type of player, but it ain't. Go! Okay, in the regulation. The game started, so we need to have a shootout.
Okay.
Man, I seen better legs on a snake.
I hope your blocking is as good as your talking.
Man, you can't be serious. All right, Joe, let's put this game to bed, okay?
What are you doing at school on a Sunday?
The same thing you're doing here. I came to play locker soccer.
But girls can't play locker soccer.
Well, in our house, everyone's equal, and that means girls can play locker soccer. Right, Carlos?
Right. George, she's on your team. I think you should let her kick first.
What? Girls can't kick.
I think Principal Fender should know that.
Who cares? Detention is 7th period for me anyway.
Well, suspension is going to be your 8th period once I tell Mr. Fender you paid off the janitor.
Man, just let her kick. The worst thing that can happen is that she misses and we get an extra turn.
Come on, what are you afraid of? To break a toenail?
Haven't you seen her toenails? She might pop the ball.
All right, you asked for it. This is for go-get-it girls everywhere.
Lorena really didn't leave Carlos any other choice. I mean, he had to do the only thing a true die-hard soccer player could do, retaliate.
Okay, first you soak your feet in this warm, soapy water, and then I'll give you your pedicure.
Uh-huh. Thanks, Mommy.
Hey, guys. If Lorena can play locker soccer, we can do this.
Ew, get your dirty feet out of my tub.
So while Lorena was learning how to be equal in all of the things we did, we were learning that we could be as equally annoying as her.
Little athlete's foot never hurt anybody.
Ew! I didn't know Ty was a fun guy.
More room for me, because my dog's shorter than me.
Did you guys see Amoria's car go last night? So good.
I'm telling you, girls are weird. So they come up with the craziest ways to pass the time.
Oh, man. It's just like crossing my... Oh, my God.
Not enough. I saw that. Was crazy. Hey, what are you girls doing?
Nothing you'd be interested in.
Try us.
Fine, giving each other tattoos.
Tattoos are for guys.
Really? Then would any of you guys like one?
Yeah, me first. Amazing girl. Loretta, that's not funny.
It is when you can't take it off for 2 weeks.
Oh, man, that's cold.
Come on, Larry.
It wasn't enough for Lorena to embarrass Carlos and George.
Oh, no.
She had to get me, too. I felt like I should just go and turn in my man card or something.
Come on, bro. Come on.
Come on, man. Reverse it, man. Come on. Come on. She's a girl.
You can do it. You can do it. You can't do it.
Man, you let a girl pin you?
Hey, let her win.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I don't believe it.
Besides, it. Pull a muscle in my back this morning.
Man, I'm not buying that, man. Let's go. Man, we're out.
Bye.
You guys can't just leave me here. Just get her off me.
You know, my dad would never admit it, but he wasn't equality's biggest fan either.
Mi amor, you're reading the food section. I'm so glad to see you're taking our new rules seriously.
Oh, yeah. Hey, look at this. Magical three-bean salad. Who knew beans were magical?
If Dad being reduced to talking about three-bean salads meant equality, then equality had no business in our house.
Mi amor, you're finished with the laundry already?
Yeah. Men just get the job done quicker. See, we don't complicate things with all that sorting.
Did you wash my white blouse?
Yeah, let me see. No, nothing white here.
The Garcia men unanimously agree that equality bites.
We need to talk to Dad.
How long do we have to be equal? Because this isn't working for me.
No kidding. I am so not going to gym class till we get new t-shirts.
These dumb new Garcia rules are ruining everything. And who wants to play with girls?
In another year, the answer to that would have been me. But at the moment, I was still feeling the burning shame of being pinned by my 62-pound sister.
Hey, I got it.
What?
I know how to make Lorena never want to play with us again.
Great. What's the plan?
We go right up to her.
Yeah?
And we say...
Yeah?
No matter what you say, we're playing with you.
Bro, I've already been down that road before.
No, man, hear me out. I'm talking about launching Operation Payback. One, two,
three. Yeah, so that would be cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Those are great cupcakes.
Thanks. It's a Garcia secret recipe, but I could give it to you for the student council bake sale tomorrow.
That would be nice of you. I mean, you aren't even on the student council.
But you could be. Leanna and I are on the nominating committee.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, girls. What you making?
Nothing.
Can we help?
No.
Cool, thanks.
Ew, stop it.
Needs more sugar.
Mommy, the boys are bugging us.
Mijos, leave the girls alone.
But if we let Lorena hang out with us, doesn't she have to let us hang out with her?
Yes, she does. Garcias are all equal, remember? Men and women can do the same things.
Fine.
Fair is fair, huh?
These look ready.
Chocolate cupcakes, cool.
Hey, I bet I can eat one of these faster than you can.
You're on. Stop it, that's gross. No. Carlos?
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm hogging all the soda. Here, let me pour you some.
Ew, backwash. That's disgusting. I can see the cupcake floating.
I said stop it.
Oh, do you guys want some too?
My dress! You ruined it!
That's it. We're out of here.
No! Wait, 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 come back!
Why did you guys do that? Those were my friends. I know you guys hate me, but it wasn't my fault I was born a girl. You think it's easy feeling like an outsider in my own family? I wish I'd been born into another family, one with girls.
At that moment, I saw Lorena for who she was, a person with feelings and not just my pesty sister. This was definitely not one of the Brothers Garcia's finest moments.
Lorena, your brothers have something to say to you.
We're sorry, Lorena.
Yeah, we're really sorry.
Me most of all, because it was my idea.
I'm sorry I got on your nerves by hanging out with you guys. I just thought if I did what you guys did, we'd be equal.
Mija, I think we gave you the wrong idea. Being equal means men and women get the chance to do the same things. Doesn't mean you have to do them.
That's right. They can like different things and they can do different things.
Lorena, I know I don't always treat you like I should, but I do care about you. I can't imagine our family without you.
Guys?
Guys! The battle between the Garcia boys and Lorena was done. Carlos had called a truce, and no one cared who won, really. I mean, we were just glad it was finally over. Well, after that, we started a new tradition of respect. Yeah, we had always loved Mom and Lorena, but now we would let them know how much we appreciated them too. My dad made sure that respect didn't just mean saying nice things, but doing nice things. Well, he even tried his hands at sewing.
Yeah, would let me help you with that.
I heard later that Band-Aid stock reached an all-time high.
Hey, guys.
Lorena, want to play?
Thanks, Larry, but you don't have to invite me to play all the time.
No, I need your help. It won't take bad.
Okay.
Lorena's on my team.
Okay, fine. But next time, I get Lorena and you get Carlos.
Hey.
Growing up in a family with three brothers could not have been easy. But I think it's what helped make my sister Lorena the great go-getter girl she became.
You're right, she is good.
Todo para la familia. Everything for the family.